So welcome to the Kenya National Theatre, and welcome to an evening with Divinity Center. My name is Mary, I'll be one of your hosts for tonight, and...
I will be your co-host, Martin Namu.
Now, we just start with a little housekeeping. The washrooms are on either side of the foyer. We have emergency exits on either side of the auditorium. And we would like you to switch off your phones. If you want to take photographs, you may, but please switch off your flashes. Thank you very much.
On behalf of Divinity Foundation, we'd like to welcome you this evening for an extravaganza, and a showcase of Divinity Foundation's empowering impoverished women and children through health and education for a better life. How are you? You look beautiful, all of you. Mary?
Yes.
How are you?
Very well, thank you, Martin.
You look amazing.
Thank you, I clean up well.
And sorry, you caught me off guard over there. My compliment?
Oh, you also clean up very well, Martin. Very dapper tonight, please.
Thank you so much. So, on behalf of the Diversity Foundation, we'd like to invite you to a showcase of Divinity Foundation's 10 years in Kenya.
But there will be a bit of a change. If you look at your programs, you'll notice that we start off with girls, but we're actually going to start off with a video that tells you about the 10 years that Divinity Foundation has been working with these young ladies and what they plan to do thereafter. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy the video.
Thank you.
So Divinity Foundation is an organization that is set up with the aim of helping children who are impoverished or orphaned or abandoned, children who need a second chance in life. And because mothers are a very important part of children, mothers then automatically also became a focus for Divinity Foundation's work. What we do is we empower children. So how do we empower these children? We empower them through our angel projects, and these are projects set up in health, in education, and of course in protection of girls from FGM and child marriages.
As a foundation, we believe that children are the future global peace ambassadors. We believe that they should be nurtured, they should be loved, and they should be given an opportunity in life, an equal opportunity in regardless of their status in the society.
4 years ago, or maybe going about five years ago, Divinity Foundation started doing medical work in Amboseli. And when we went into Amboseli, we did find that there was a high prevalence of women who were suffering with things like pelvic infections, urine infections, and a few cases of fistula. When we started to dig deeper into the causes of such a high percentage of women having these issues, it was directly linked to FGM. So FGM stands for female genital mutilation. When we started to talk to community elders, government representatives, children's office, the police in that area, what we did find was that there was a very high percentage. We're talking about 98% of the girls in Amboseli are directly affected by female genital mutilation. The big challenge that they had in Amboseli was that when a girl was rescued by the police or the children's office, there was absolutely no place for them to put this child. So the only place they could put a girl was in jail with criminals, which is not ideal. So what they desperately needed to bring about change was a protection center, a safe house where girls who have been rescued from FGM could be sort of housed. So we had a series of roundtable meetings, and because of those roundtable meetings, the Maasai elders in Amboseli decided to donate 5 acres of land. And on that 5 acres of land, what we then did was we built a self-sustaining project, an FGM Protection and Rescue Center.
Currently, we've got 28 girls at the Protection Center. The number is never static. We've got a flow of girls coming in, and immediately the girls come in, we try and start the process of reintegrating them back to their families with the help of the Social Services Department and the Children's Office. While the girls are at our center, we provide free education to them, we provide health services to them, we provide meals, we also ensure that they take part in sports and music, which we find quite therapeutic, but above all we do trauma counseling for these young girls who have undergone a lot of emotional tantrums.
The center also has its own little farm, dairy farm and vegetable farm, so that it is a self-sustaining project with solar power and borehole water supply. What we found is that since we've been in Amboseli, we've got this center, we have got girls, we do a lot of outreach work with the community, we go out into villages and we empower girls and let them know that they have the right to say no to FGM and no to child marriages.
We also run biomedical camps throughout the year, 2 or 3 times a year. We get volunteers from Europe who come in and they join our local team of doctors and team and staff, and we go out in the community. We treat women and children. One medical camp of 14 days sees us to treat around 2,000 to 3,000 patients, both in the urban slums and rural areas. We also run a community hospital in Makindu, in partnership with the Sikh Temple Makindu and the Amrit Foundation. This hospital is key to us because it gives the surrounding community an opportunity to have access to affordable healthcare system, but above all, it's very good quality healthcare, which is more important because to us, we believe that everybody should have a right to both quality and affordable healthcare system.
Today's main object is we need to put a hospital there. We don't have any hospital close there. Initially we had 3 acres of plot. We've got another 3 in total. I've got 6 acres. So we thought that we definitely need a hospital to look after the children there, and then again for the maternity. We don't have anything close by there, so we would want a hospital to take care of the ladies there, the mothers and the children. So that's the main thing, and this project would cost us about 15 million shilling. Whatever we've collected today is going to go towards the construction of the hospital. Some of our girls, they are very bright girls, they would actually be nurses and they will be doctors one day. So definitely after this education, we want them to come back in this hospital, work here, look after everybody, and then they will actually have a very nice life and a living there. Thank you so much.
These girls have been empowered, their families have been empowered, they're teaching them about alternative rites of passage, they're giving them skills that will help them later on in life. Thank you so much for each and everybody who has supported this foundation thus far. Now we carry on expecting young girls to come out, very beautiful girls, very talented. Young Maasai girls who are excellent singers, excellent performers, so I hope you enjoy. Thank you. February 2010. Our work continues in beautiful Kenya, full of color, vibrancy, and culture, where the cracks of society are filled with adverse poverty and daily challenges faced by marginalized communities. Life is full of challenges, no doubt about it. But the mark of a human is how they face those challenges, and most importantly, how they uplift others to face their challenges. This week, our Divinity team has ventured into the beautiful area of Amboseli, home to the Maasai, a vibrant tribe who weave a beautiful tapestry of their vibrant reds and blues. Against the backdrop of Mount Kilimanjaro, majestic landscapes and wildlife only previously seen on National Geographic. Deep in this land, the emotional, physical, and psychological health of girls is at risk due to the age-old tradition of female genital mutilation. Their childhood is robbed. They blame culture. But these days, poverty forces parents to sell their girls in marriage to old men enough to be their grandfathers for 15 kilograms of tea leaves and sugar. We must be the light of hope for these girls. Asi, asi, asi. and the light of hope we have become. In 2014, we opened our doors to the FGM Protection and Rescue Center in Amboseli, giving girls fleeing female genital mutilation safe refuge. Today, there is a wave of change slowly rippling through the community, a wave of positive change for the girl child. There is a new dawn in this place called Amboseli, whose ripples will be felt all over Kenya. It is my dream that one day our children won't have to face hardships. Girls won't be forced into FGM or child marriage or child labor. There is much work to be done. We shall succeed. One day at a time, one person at a time. For we are the change makers of divinity. girls have done absolutely marvelous. Let's give them another round of applause. Let's encourage them. And at this point, I'm going to hand over to my co-host, Martin. So he'll be walking up and he'll be taking us through the next stage of the program. Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize. There's one more song. Girls, proceed. To my co-MC, Martin.
Thank you very much, Mary.
You're most welcome.
That was amazing. Give another round of applause, please. Beautiful, courageous ladies. Those are beautiful, powerful performances. We thank you so much again for joining us this evening. And this is, right now, we'd like to celebrate the new wave of change that joins us in making sure Divinity Foundation's wing of hope flies high over African skies, uplifting communities and nurturing children. For the next bit, we'll have some more music. Give it up for vocal artist, guitarist extraordinaire, Ben Soul. Hi everyone, so my name is Ben Soul, B-N-S-O-U-L, and this is some of my music. I hope you enjoy. So this one's called Your Favorite Song.
majani na mandazi. Such a lovely way to start my day. We can make us and make you call my name. To kiss you za ngoma za bomale. Napenda vile una smile usisare. Nipatie zeze nikuimie. I wrote a song na nataka usikie. If you let me sing for you. Such a lovely day with my lady. For many just love is what I'm feeling. I bless the day when you came my way. And I promise kuwanita kuenzi. Baby time imefika for 20. And I can see you back to my penzi. So won't you let me sing for you?
The next one is called Mtala Nawe. It's a song in Swahili. It means I will eat with you, you know.
Mpenzi we, usiwe na mashaka. Ingawa maji, kesho tutatoboa. Nikiwa kwa raha, tufurahi pamoja. Na ninapolia, we wanipa faraja. Mtala nawe, mtala nawe. Kwenye shida, ama kwenye furaha dada. Mtala nawe, mtala nawe. Kwenye jua ama kwenye mvua. Mtala nawe, mtala nawe. Kwenye shida ama kwenye furaha dada. Mtala nawe, mtala nawe. Zetu zinavyometa meta. Na ukitabasa unapendeza sana. Nikiwa kwa giza umekuwa mwangaza. Tuliopitia umenivumilia dada. Mtala nawe, mtala nawe. Kwenye shida ama kwenye furaha dada. Mtala nawe, mtala nawe. ama kwenye mvua. Mtala nawe, mtala nawe, kwenye shida ama kwenye furaha dada. Mtala nawe, mtala nawe, kwenye jua ama kwenye mvua.
Thank you so much. My last song for the night is called Make a Difference. I believe you guys came here to make a difference. If you love my music, I left my card on one of the desks before outside there. And thank you guys so much for coming to support the girls, you know. So this one's called Make a Difference.
What a way. Listen to what the old man said. Don't stray away from your way, no. Learn to defend your name, no. That's the only way you will learn to live a life of truth. See, the young generation is watching in every step you take. Have them in your mind. You know, we will make a difference in the eyes. Yeah. And it will make a difference in our lives. Yeah. And it will make a difference in our lives. We will make a difference. We will make a difference. We will make a difference in our lives. Yeah, now we will make a difference. We will make a difference. We will make a difference. Teach your son to stay away from the guns, and teach your daughter crime will never make things better. Teach them how to love and stay together in harmony. Let's all sing a peace, and they will hear. You know we will make a Yeah. And it will make a difference in our lives. Yeah. We will make a difference in their lives. Oh, 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 oh. And it will make a difference in our lives. If you believe it, say it with me. No. We will make a difference. Sing it with me. We will make a difference. Yeah. We will make a difference in our lives. Help me sing, you know. We will make a difference. Yeah, we will make a difference. Yeah, we will make a difference in our lives. I can't hear you. We will make a difference. Oh, yeah. We will make a difference. Oh, yeah. We will make a difference. Now I like it. Oh, oh, oh. We will make a difference. We will make a difference. We will make a difference in their lives.
Thank you so much. I love you guys. My name is Ben Soul, BENSOUL. Check me out on all the platforms. And we have a new song out. It's called Telenovela. Thank you. Respect and love. All right.
That's
So, everybody, give it up. Making a difference. One string at a time, I guess. But it's not just about making a difference, it's actually about committing to it. Yes, this is the serious part of the evening when we have the speeches. The people who founded Divinity Foundation. These are not small matters we're talking about. We're trying to make a difference. I have great honor welcoming the woman whose vision Divinity Foundation is to the Divinity family. She is mother, friend, and compassionate change maker. Navdeep Madharu.
Good evening, everybody. I want to thank you all for being here tonight. And I don't want to stand here for half an hour or an hour talking about Divinity, but we've got, I think the girls are doing an amazing job. And when I think about these girls on the very first day they came to our rescue center, many of them didn't even speak English. A lot of them had undergone experiences that you'd find unimaginable. And today I'm seeing very confident young ladies on the stage, and that gives me a great deal of pleasure. I actually conceived Divinity Foundation in a space of 2 weeks. Maybe it was the Immaculate Conception. And it was during the election violence of 2007 when we decided that we really needed to do something. And it's taken us 10 years, and I was sitting there the other day and trying to figure out how many people Divinity Foundation, my baby, has helped. And annually, for the past 10 years, I have reached out and made a difference to about 30,000 lives. So over the past 10 years, I've touched 300,000. It's an okay figure, and I believe that we can do much, much, much better. I don't really know what else to tell you about Divinity Foundation. It's my passion. It's what I live for. Everybody else is married and they have children, while Divinity is my little baby. And all of the kids that we help are my babies, not only these girls. We also support and help children who have undergone rape. So we have a rape protection center in Nairobi. Then we're going to build a hospital in 2019. And I know that that hospital will be providing free and subsidized care for mothers and children. And most importantly, we also performing C-section surgeries for young child brides who are pregnant, and also women who have fistulas. You might be wondering why women and children and why not men, because I get asked this question a lot. And people usually say, Nav, do you hate men? No, I don't hate men, I actually love men. Men are amazing. But why women and children? Well, men can look after themselves. They're supposed to be the stronger parts of our society. Women, because they're the midwives of our generation. They give birth, they nurture our coming generation. And children, because what you put into them today, the seeds you plant and you nurture, is what you'll reap tomorrow. So when people talk about wanting a world that is peaceful and a happy world, it's not going to happen unless we start planting those seeds of compassion and love in our children today. And that's every child, not a child that's born in our home and we have luxury. It's every child. It's that street child. It's the girl child who's struggling in this country, in this society. You have to plant seeds of love and compassion. And I know that all of these girls are going to be change makers. They're ambassadors. And it gives me great joy when I ask these girls, what do you want to be in life? I have some of them telling me they want to be a pilot. I don't think that any of them had ever dreamt of being a pilot, but that was after some random MREF medical helicopter used our field to land on, and they were absolutely amazed by a helicopter that they'd never seen before. And so some of them said, we want to be a pilot when we grow up. Here's an amazing fact. All of these girls, 23 of them have never been to Nairobi City in their life. This is the very first time they've come to Nairobi City. When they come to Nairobi City and we take them to a mall, they're actually shit scared of going on the escalators and on the lifts because that's something so new for them. And they're so excited. I remember last Christmas, as a Christmas treat, I took them to Diani, and it was the very first time they'd seen the ocean, the very first time they'd stepped on a beach. And again, they were scared. They didn't know what this white sand was. And they were scared of jellyfish and sea urchins. And so it was so special to be part of that little journey of discovery. And that's what Divinity does. We empower children, we empower mothers. But the great part for us is that we get to see the enlightenment and the change that we're making. So thank you everybody for being here. Thank you for supporting Divinity. I've done it for 10 years and now I know I have an even stronger team who are gonna lead us through the next 10 years with a hospital and of course more change makers. So thank you so much.
Now, Matari, everybody. Very inspiring. It takes guts to start up something by yourself, to be the change that you hope for the world. And so this is part of the reason why this event, raising awareness, also trying to challenge you to be part of the mission. And tonight you're officially part of the mission. Divinity's global ambassadors, which is a key point of this. These are individuals who are passionate about humanity and positive change. Individuals in the public eye who utilize their popularity to highlight adversities faced by communities. Tonight, one of our global ambassadors of change, His Excellency Ambassador Joseph Helen, Africa's renowned jazz musician, is here. Joseph understands all too well rising from adversity into a life of hope and success. He mentors and tutors talented youngsters from impoverished backgrounds into some of the finest musicians on the continent so that they may live a life of success and dignity. And as they do, they carry forward this ripple of uplifting others. But I hear there might be something else.
Yes, before we introduce Joseph,
Before we introduce Joseph. Tell us more. Is there going to be a surprise?
Well, I'm not too sure because I'm getting some information from backstage and I think I need to confirm.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm not too sure because I know Joseph Helen. I saw him seated there. Yes, Joseph, give us, stand up. A round of applause.
His Excellency Ambassador Joseph Helen, everybody.
So we'd like Joseph to come up on stage before we introduce somebody very special.
Divinity's global ambassador, His Excellency Joseph Helen, everybody. Round of applause.
Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are you? I can barely see your faces. I like to see people. Oh, there you are. Wonderful. Thank you so much for such an awesome opportunity to address you one more time as your global ambassador. I'd like to especially acknowledge the chairman, Baljit. Where are you? Over there. Come on, let's just give him a round of applause. Great man. I remember when I was a youngster, my wife was starting a music school. Bajit opened his school somewhere in Gigiri. I told my wife, you can use some of this space to establish your institution. And I'm telling you, a great dream has come out of that and something extremely successful. So thank you, Mr. Bajit. And then, of course, Nav. Can we just applaud Nav, ladies and gentlemen? What a sweet-spirited fellow. So gentle, yet so focused, and so determined. I remember her attending some of my jazz performances, and she'd be there, focused on every single note. And she knows how to listen to music. And that's how our relationship began. But ladies and gentlemen, tonight I'd like to talk to you very briefly about faded dreams. That little girl, somewhere in Maasai land, in the mother's womb, kicking, sucking the thumb, punching, ready for life. And then a little later, the child is born into a world that has endless possibilities. But then, the hopes of this child to succeed in life and to become something is dashed one day when an unscrupulous, self-made doctor with a crude weapon snuffs out her womanhood in the name of culture. And it's for this reason, ladies and gentlemen, that we gather on a night like this to not only say no to such barbaric acts, but to take these children by the hand and show them hope and show them that it's possible to live a better life. You can almost hear in your imaginative mind the screams and the shrills of this child. In the night, dusty, dry night, where the poignant howls of hyenas and barking dogs pierce the night with chilly fear, and this little girl does not know what the next day holds. And you can almost see a young girl, 12 years old, being led by an old man into an unholy matrimony because of early childhood marriage. And Divinity Foundation has stood firm and has taken it in stride. The very noble task of not only supporting, but defending these impoverished, abandoned, and even orphaned members of our society. For that reason, we applaud Divinity Foundation. And I'm especially very proud, honored, and privileged to be a global ambassador in such a wonderful institution. Can we just give a round of applause to Divinity Foundation? Ladies and gentlemen, there is a musician called Alan Walker. And this musician immortalized something through song. The song is called Faded. And if you look at the video, there is this gentleman in a go-down, impoverished, wearing tattered clothes, not knowing what tomorrow holds. And as he walks in this wide hall, without food, without hope, he hears a sound. Where are you? Are you in Atlantis? Are you just in the imaginations of my mind? What happened to you? Are you still there? And the hope is rekindled in his heart. And he steps out of this go-down, ready to face a world with somebody's arms stretched open to welcome him into success and dreams that are unfaded. Ladies and gentlemen, I play the saxophone. But tonight, I want a young fellow who comes from a wonderful family. This family helps young girls by donating sanitary towels in their own small but special way. And this family has a little girl called Nea. Nea, where are you? Just wave at me wherever you are. Yes, she's over there. This little girl has learned the art of philanthropy so early, and she wants to participate in looking after those who are disadvantaged in the society. And she's got a brother called Rian Goswali. This gentleman plays the saxophone, and I'm privileged to be his teacher. And he's going to give us an instrumental version of a song called Faded, just to transport your souls and your spirits into that world of love and care. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together as I introduce Rian on the alto saxophone. Come. How old are you, Rian?
I just turned 11.
This guy just turned 11. And what's that shiny thing you're holding?
Saxophone.
How long have you played the saxophone?
About 1 year.
About 1 year. And what do you have to offer us tonight?
I'm going to play Faded.
You're going to play Faded. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Wonderful. Just set yourself up. It's interesting that nowadays you can read notes from the laptop. During our days, you had to get an actual piece of paper with notes on it. Nowadays, at the click of a button, the notes just come forth and you play and play, and it's just so wonderful. Are you ready? Almost there? All right, I think it's ready. Can you just stop it and start it again? And if you can give him just a bit more volume. I choose to have him play instead of me playing, because this is the future. Thank you. round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Rian. Hasn't he done well? He played every single note right, believe me. I was standing there watching everything. Well, I don't have any more to say. He's spoken it all. The faded dreams are unfading. Have a wonderful evening.
Thank you so much. Wasn't that amazing? My word, it's like Ambassador Helen, you taught him exactly what to do. Tell us. Just a little, you know, jazzy puns. Right. A piece de resistance. And now introduce to you the man whose vision will lead Divinity forward into its next 10 years. The Kenya chairman, Baljit Virdhi.
Thank you so much. A very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you're not hungry or sleepy. A good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Ambassador Helen, karibu sana. Thank you for coming over today with your family. 6 years ago, I volunteered at Divinity Foundation's first fundraiser organized by my daughter Monique at Sikinia Club. I think some of you were there, that's 6 years ago. This was to raise money for the construction of a rescue center for young girls rescued from child marriage and FGM. And that's when my journey at Divinity Foundation started. Shortly after that, RYA approached us to build a borehole which would provide access to free, clean water, serve approximately 1,000 people every single day. Thank you to the East African Rwanda Board who are present here today. I'm now proud to say that we are now a fully fledged FGM Rescue Protection Center, which cares for girls in danger. However, our job doesn't stop here. Divinity Foundation's primary objective is to stand as a beacon of hope, humanity, and healing by uplifting lives and making the world we live in more vibrant. We believe in empowering young lives into future ambassadors of global peace and prosperity. In 2019, we will be embarking on two of our biggest projects in Amboseli. The first planned project of 2019 is a maternity and children's community hospital, which will serve an approximate catchment of over 1,000 families, providing access to healthcare to communities living as far as Chilu Hills. I'm sure most of you have gone there, Amboseli, so you know where the Chilu Hills and what we're talking about. To take you slightly back, we took over the management of Sikh Hospital Mukindo in 2015, when the hospital was running with a staff of 5 people. We have implemented a wider menu of services, which are either free or subsidized. Today, we have a staff of 25 dedicated personnel, and are bringing in enough money to make this project self-sustainable. Let me like to thank George, our manager there, George, Lawrence Wahab, a very big thank you for doing a wonderful job at Mukindo Sikh Temple. The setup for our maternity and children's hospital is even more crucial for me when I heard a story of one of our girls. You've seen all these girls who've been here. Nav, she's the mother of all these girls. She told you that these girls, most of them, first time they've come to Nairobi. Imagine
Tomorrow, we've got a meeting to take the girls to Parliament buildings. They're coming with us to Parliament tomorrow. We're trying to organize a visit to the State House, God willing. If not tomorrow, soon, these girls will be in State House. At the age 5, she was separated from her mother and she was sent to live as an ayah looking for children. She saw children going to school, yet she herself was forbidden. At the age 9, she started visiting a nearby school, begging teachers to give her admission. Finally, she got admission. For 2 years she attended the school. She got severely caned when she got home for ignoring her duties as an ayah, because she was an ayah, not to go for schooling. The dream of this girl is to be a doctor. She is here with us, one of these girls. Through Divinity Foundation, she is now in a secondary school, straight A student, with a vision to be a doctor of her own community. This girl will start going to a school in Nairobi with other children who have mobile phones, ministers, governor's children. This girl is going to school at that school. She is. This girl will be a doctor in our hospital, and there will be no greater testimony to the unique brand. Hope, humanity, and healing, Divinity spreads. Our second planned project for 2019 is to set up a sustainable farming to support the FGM Rescue Center, create agricultural jobs for both the Rescue Center girls once they've completed their education and nearby communities. We have given these girls education. Soon they need employment from us. So that's the reason we said, let's get a hospital in, let's get farming. These girls you've seen here today will become the owners of their own place. Everything the hospital farming, they will become the owners of this place. We'll be installing a simple irrigation technology to generate sustainable farming environment for our girls. A project led by some youngsters we've had with us, led by Sahil Patel, Erico International Limited, Kenya-based irrigation company. Sahil, thank you so much, you and your friends here today. In addition to the farming, we will also increase the number of cows we have at the center to produce milk, breed more chicken for eggs. Once this project is underway, we'll be selling our produce to nearby hotels and communities in order to increase our revenue to sustain the farming project, the hospital and rescue center. We've got our community members from the Kuku Range, Henry, John, Saruni. Today, I want to let you know, in next 5 years, this small village, we want to convert into a town. And with all your help, we'll convert this small village into a town in 5 years. Ladies and gentlemen, with these two projects, I hope you can see we are serving for a self-sustainable center for girls. Once they complete their education, given agile training and secure a job at either the hospital or the agriculture business. Before I sign off, I would like to take this opportunity to thank all of you here today for attending and supporting our work. I would like also to thank all our sponsors, without whom our work here at Divinity Foundation would not be possible. Thank you. God bless you all. Sandisana. Thank you.
Clearly a man with a Clearly a man with a vision, Mr. Verdi. Yes. It isn't easy to stand up on stage talking about these things and putting a smile on your face, to be honest. because just like the tagline for Divinity Foundation, we're trying to change people's lives one at a time. And tonight we get to be part of the mission, all of us, simply by attending. So I'd like to thank you all again. In fact, you should give yourselves a round of applause for being here tonight, dressed as beautifully as you are. Thank you so much. We have that surprise we were talking about, if I am not mistaken. We were not kidding. I have a feeling that if I find a way to entice Ambassador Joseph Helen to come and join the beautiful, powerful voices up on stage, is it possible, sir? Kindly do us a favor and join us, be the global ambassador, and inspire us all to be global ambassadors for Divinity Foundation. Thank you so much.
You know, Nav wanted me to play the saxophone, but in one of my business troubles, some fellow snatched my phone and sprained my little finger. So I'm not able to play so much. So maybe I'll just sing with these ones. What's the song? Okay, you start the song, I'll join you.
Help us sing.
You
raise me up to walk on stormy sea.
Come on, sing.
I am strong when I am on your shoulder. You raise me up to more than I can see.
You raise me up.
Sing along, sing along. Amazing. And your teacher over there, Mr. Ohas. Awesome. You've done a great job with these children. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not easy to sing in pitch a cappella without instruments. And these ones are able to sing from the first note to the last exactly on pitch. Please applaud them. It's a great achievement. With beautiful voices and beautiful harmonies. Thank you so much.
Ambassador.
Powerful voices. Ambassador, she was also powerful, but would have loved you with the saxophone, you know that. My host, Mary.
So I am now going to give the vote of thanks. I would like to thank the sponsors, Seneca Security, Stone Arts, Safari Trails, Fabulous Printers, Nikon Cameras, Spice Roots, Ogman Printers, Lyra Waters, and a very special thanks to our Divinity staff who have worked hard at putting all of this together. And could they all please join us on stage? Manjeet, Joxy, Lawrence, Kevin, Rahab, Caroline, Carolina, Baljeet, our Rescue Center staff who have done an amazing job, night and day. They've been here every single moment. Could you please come up? Daniel, Amos, Charles, Mama Raba, Guapi, come on. And everybody now, please give them a round of applause. They've been here day and night, working very hard, ensuring that the show is the success that it is today. Absolutely amazing. We'd like to also thank our VIPs, our dignitaries, Ambassador Joseph Helen, Asante, thank you so much. We'd also like to thank our dear narrator, Martin, myself, Victoria, everybody else who has supported us from the sound crew, the support crew, Kenya National Theatre. Thank you so much. And to all of you who came out tonight to spend the evening with us. We don't take this for granted. Thank you very much. Give yourselves a pat on the shoulder. And we wish you a safe journey home and God bless you all. Thank you. Oh, gosh. So everybody...